And welcome to Art with Anna. Today we are going to look at another contemporary artist, and his name is Liu Wei. He is from China. He is still living. He was born in the 60s. He lives in Beijing, China right now, and a lot of his work focuses on the urbanization of China right now. Specifically of Beijing. So we'll look at a few of his artworks, but we're just going to remake one of them today. First, before we get started too much, let's talk about the supplies that we'll need.
We will need some really bright colored construction paper. So the more bright you can find, the better. Neon would be preferred.
You also need black construction paper. You'll need brightly colored paint. Think like neon colors. If you don't have neon colors, like yellows, oranges, bright colors like that. And you also need a blue. You can use two different shades of blue, or you can also use one shade of blue with white. If you have a paper cutter like this, that would be ideal. If not, scissors will be necessary. Glue, paintbrush, and dish for water. That should be all that you need for your project today.
So Liu Wei is a contemporary artist, like I mentioned, and contemporary art is a art movement or style that is categorized by being anywhere from the 1960s to 70s to today. So contemporary just means happening right now. So this artwork is happening right now. And a big theme of contemporary artists are globalization, because that's kind of a new concept, as well as just politics, social justice, and reacting to the environment around them. So in Liu's case, Beijing is really building a lot of new giant buildings. They're tearing down a lot of older, smaller buildings for these new buildings, and that's been most of his inspiration for a lot of his art, and his main inspiration for the art that we'll be talking about today. So let's look at the art that we'll be focusing on and talk a little bit about it. So this artwork we'll be focusing on is called Purple Air, and it's actually a series of paintings all under this name, Purple Air. Now, as you can see here, we have kind of a purplish background with some kind of pixelated, almost looking modern buildings. I think they look like buildings. It's supposed to look like a cityscape. There's a sun there, and you can see that there's rings around it. I think that does possibly represent some haze, and maybe that's why it's called purple air. I'm not exactly sure about that, but I know that in some areas in China, air quality is an issue. And that's because of some pollution. So possibly he's making a comment about that and all the big buildings that are being built, maybe contributing to that. I'm not exactly sure. We'd have to ask him, but that's something I think about when looking at this. And he does say that he doesn't think of art as being a means to answer questions, but instead it should be something that makes you ask more questions. So I think here we can ask the question, maybe the purple air has something to do with air quality. I don't know. But this is what we'll be working on today. So first, get started, we're going to grab a background color. If you have pink or purple paper, that would probably be best for the background, but any of the brightly colored papers that you have chosen will work fine as a background. So let's grab that out, and let's grab out something to put our paint colors on, some sort of palette or just an extra piece of paper, and we'll start a little bit of painting.
All right, so I am grabbing my two blue colors. Now again, if you don't have two blue colors, you can do a blue and then add some white to make a lighter blue. So I have a darker blue and a lighter blue. I'm also gonna grab some pinks and some yellows right now. So these are gonna be, this is my palette for right now that we'll be using. And let me just put these on my palette. So one of the features on some of these paintings are mountains in the background. So that is something we are gonna paint first on our piece of paper here. So something I wanna talk to you guys about is something called atmospheric perspective. So when you look at a photo of mountains, or you see a painting of mountains or trees in the distance, the first mountain is always a darker color, and the second mountain that's behind it or further away is always a lighter color. Now you might be wondering why that is. And that's because there's always water vapor in the air, and sometimes there's pollution and different things in the air also. And light has a harder time traveling through it. So the things further back that have more water vapor between it and your eye appear lighter. So our first mountain we're going to use making our lighter blue color. And I'm just going to make a mountain shape. Here in the middle of my artwork here. And I'm going to fill that in. Now, mountain landscapes are very traditional in Chinese artwork. So I do think that Liu Wei is maybe paying homage to that by doing mountains in some of his artwork. It could also just be that there are mountains in China. That's why it's popular in the artwork. And maybe that was in the background of what he was painting. I'm not sure, but it is pretty traditional for Chinese artist to do mountain landscapes. So now that we have our furthest mountain away, it's going to be kind of our bigger one. We're going to do a smaller mountain shape. It doesn't have to be exactly, in fact, it shouldn't be exactly like the one behind it. There are two different mountains. Doing just an organic, no right or wrong, real mountain way to do in the front. But we are going to make it a little bit of a darker shape. And this is a lot like how Liu Wei does his paintings. He usually starts with the background painting mountains, if he has that in his painting, and also painting the sky. So let's do that next. We're going to clean off our brush and our water. And with a clean brush, I'm going to go in, since this is purple air, that's the theme of these paintings. I'm gonna make some purpley colors with my pink and mix in my blue a little bit also. So I'm gonna take some of my pink. Let's see if I can show you guys a little bit. And I'm mixing it with some blue. And we're gonna make a nice shade of purple here. And I'm going to make pretty big bands, just straight lines. Now, Liu Wei's lines are perfectly straight. Mine will not be. And if yours aren't, that's okay too. If they are, more power to you. I'm very impressed. Got these big bands of kind of purple color back here. Now, you might need to use some hand over hand from someone helping you to make these straight lines. That's great. Maybe we could do hand over hand with the person helping us a few times to go like this, but then maybe for the third time, they just let us do it on our own. I did get a tip from Ace in Green Bay. There are people who use RPM to communicate, and they have a day program in a school. And they say, if you have an extra sheet of paper somewhere, you can take that, and then you can practice your straight lines on that extra piece of paper without having too much pressure to mess up, right? You can do some practice before you do it on your final product. So we have one band here. I'm going to do one more bigger band down here that goes kind of behind our mountains. So you'll want to be a little careful there. And feel free to go over your mountains again in the blue, too, if you covered them. And I'm going to make just a different shade of purple. So our last purple was kind of a more blue shade, and this one's going to be a more pink shade of purple. Next to our mountain, and over. Something I really love about painting that you can't necessarily do in watercolors. So with acrylic painting or oil paints, is that you can go over, put layers and layers on top. So if you make a move that you didn't like, or you use a color that you didn't like, you can always go over it and change it. Now, something Liu Wei does quite a bit is always, he's working on his color palettes. So say he put down this color right here that I'm using and he thought it was too pink, then no problem. He'd just paint right over it with a different shade, change his palette. Now, something I think that's cool about him, and also cool about another artist from China who has a similar last name, Ai Weiwei, right? Very close to Liu Wei. They both employ people from around their studios to do some of the painting for them. So they come up with the ideas and they make kind of a rendering of it on the computer. And then they employ people around them who are looking for work and don't have work. And they teach them how to paint and how to paint these artworks. So I think that's something that people think is controversial because he's not actually doing the painting aspect of it, even though he's coming up with the artwork. I think is something that really might benefit his community. All right, so here we have our mountains. We have our bands of color for the sky. So we really do have purple air back there. Another thing that's pretty standard in these paintings is his use of the sun. So at first, we have kind of like a light, it looks hazy because there's so many rings of the sun. So I'm gonna make a big circular shape here. And I'll do one or two more rings around that. In fact, I think I will add a little pink and just go around the outside, this orange color. And then we'll let that dry a little bit. And if we choose, we can add another circle in the middle there. So this is what your product should look like so far. But while you're working on that, I'm going to talk a little bit about another artwork that Liu Wei has also made in a similar theme. All right, so Liu Wei,
He makes a lot of art that makes you ask questions about the things that are going on around him in this day and age, hence contemporary art. Now, again, something that's happening a lot is they're tearing down small villages or areas, older areas in Beijing, to build really big buildings that bring business, right? So one of the artworks that he uses to kind of ask questions about maybe how worth it that is he made this artwork here. It's called Love It or Bite It. And what he's done is he's made a lot of very famous buildings, Colosseum, the Pentagon, a lot of different very famous and important buildings from around the world. But he's made them in an interesting and a strange medium. He is using the skins of pigs. And in China and all around, really, pig skins are used in dog chewing toys or like treats. And so he's trying to kind of poke fun, because when he uses this very thin, not super sturdy material and he makes these buildings, they kind of start to collapse on themselves. They don't look perfect, do they? So I think he's tried to maybe poke a little fun at the big buildings that have gone up around the world. I don't think he necessarily disrespects them, but I think he's asking us to question them. So I think that's a really interesting piece that he's done about the same subject as we're talking about today. So moving on, we have so far this part of our painting. Drenik is looking really good. I am going to put another circle inside my sun, and the next step is going to be to grab out either our paper cutter or scissors, whichever you have on hand. The paper cutter is easier to use because we're going to just be making tons and tons of strips, cutting out tons and tons of strips of our other colored papers. And to save time, you can stack, I think, maybe two. Three might be a little too much, but two pieces of paper and cut strips out of them at the same time. So that's an option too. So I'm going to do that circle in my sun, and then we'll get started cutting strips, and we'll talk about the next step after that. All right, so I have my paper cutter here, and my goal right now is to just cut out many strips of paper. Make sure you're cutting strips out of your black. The black is going to create a lot of contrast between it and the bright colors, both of the background of your painting, but also the bright colors of the other strips of paper that you're cutting out. Feel free to cut out, try to make them as straight as possible, as even, but any different sizes is great. Some thicker, some thinner, you want some variety here. So we'll just take our paper cutter and drag it along here. Mine has two little draggers there. All right, and then we are left with some strips. So let's keep on going with that, I guess. And we will talk again when we're done with that. I'm also gonna talk about one more piece of art that Liu Wei is known for while we're cutting out our paper. So while you're cutting out your paper, one of the other artworks that I think is on this theme and very interesting is another sculptural work by Liu Wei, and it is called Merely a Mistake 2, number 7. It's kind of a long title, but it's called Merely a Mistake, and this piece is this beautiful sculpture, and it's made up of scraps found after demolition of old buildings. So he finds old windows, scraps, frames, doors from places that have been torn down for new buildings to be built, and he reconstructs them in a new building of their own that's really beautiful. So I think this is another really interesting piece by him that, again, is talking about what's going on around him in his country, in his city, just around him. He did have to move recently out of his studio of 10 years because it is in a neighborhood that is being rebuilt into something bigger. So I think this hit home for him, and this was something that's very important, and we see that a lot in his art. So continue cutting out your strips of paper, and when you're done, we will reconvene to assemble and finish our piece. Okay, so this is where we should be, where we have our painting done, we have our strips cut out, and now it's just assembly. So in front of the painting, we are going to put buildings that kind of obstruct our view of what is in the background. And that's just simply going to be laying different strips of paper kind of in different rectangles. So if I put this kind of down like this, and I glue these down, we will have our first building. There we go, kind of like that. That'll be our first building, and you can do them at different heights. So this one's pretty tall, it's up to the sun. We'll do the next one spaced a little further apart down here, maybe do another tall one. So you'll want tall, different buildings, and you can do them in varying widths too. So this one is kind of four skinnier strips and one thick one. You could do maybe like another one will be two thicker strips with a few thinner ones on top of it. However you want to make your buildings, we just want to make sure that they're done with multiple strips and multiple heights. So let's get started on it. All right, so this is what I am left with. And as you can see, I have some pieces hanging over the bottom. So I'm just gonna trim those off. And then I'm gonna call it good. So I'm just gonna grab my, if you have scissors, that'd be totally fine. I just didn't grab scissors since I have my paper cutter. So I'm going to slide my piece of artwork under. Maybe. There we go. And cut all of that off at the bottom. All right, so this is my final product. I think it looks pretty good. I think Liu Wei would be impressed by what we've done. And I think he's just a really cool guy to learn about. I think sometimes we get really focused about everything that goes on in the US. We don't really think about people who live in other countries, what things they're dealing with. So sometimes it's exciting to learn about people who are different from you and from different parts of the world. And I was excited today to talk to you guys about Liu Wei. All right, so I finally just glued everything down a little bit better because it was kind of coming apart. And again, there we go. So as always, I can't wait to see what you guys make. If you make something and I don't get a chance to see it because you are not at Benjamin's Hope, please send me a picture. I love seeing them. Other than that, I hope you guys have a great week. It was fun making art with you today, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye.